السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. أبو بكر.
أيوة هجاز. إسرائيل. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين، سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد الأمين، على آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. قال الناظم رحمه الله تعالى ونفعنا ببركاته: مخلق لزوجة أو عبدي، عاص وعاص، شافع في حدي، تعلم الفقه أو التصوف، لكسب مال أو لنيل شرفي، أما للاحتماء من ظلم فلا منع، بل الأجر له مكملا، ومسبل في عرضه للمرتمي، أذنب لا إن اغتفى باض ضمي، مؤدب أفحش في السب عدا، كما عدا إذا يسب الوالدة. المؤلف هنا رحمه الله تعالى ذكر تخليق الزوجة على زوجها، وهو السعي في فساد خلقها على زوجها. هذا أن يخلق الشخص، سواء كان قريبا أبا أو أما، أخا أو أختا أو صديقا، زوجة رجل على زوجها، يفسد طباعها. هذا من الكبائر والعياذ بالله. You have to be in place and strong.
I'm already adding. Bucker. It's adding you right now. It's adding you right now.
عليكم. سامحني.
طيب، هل سمعت الكلام؟
آخر
طيب، إن شاء الله أنا تعرف. نعم، الناظم هنا تكلم رحمه الله تعالى عن تخليق الزوجة على زوجها، أنا السعي في إفساد خلقها وإبعادها من زوجها، سواء كان ذلك من أم أو أب أو قريب، أخ أو أخت أو صديق، هذا من الكبائر والعياذ بالله تعالى. فاللازم على الإنسان أن يبتعد من أمور الزوجين بينهما، إلا من كان ذا علم وفهم بأمور الدين ليصلح بينهما، وإلا فليبتعد من ذلك، فإن الأمر خطير جدا.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, the all merciful, the especially merciful. May Allah's peace, blessings, honor, mercy, and elevation be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his family and companions and followers until the day of judgment. Glory be to you, O Allah, and far from imperfection are you. We have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. Indeed, you are the all-knowing and the all-wise. The matter at hand mentioned here by the author is that giving or inciting a woman against her husband, whether it's by her family, whether it's by her friends, whether it's by anyone, for no reason, for no Islamic reason, to get involved in between them and to incite her against her husband is forbidden. It is from the major sins to do so, to get involved. And it's from one of the most dangerous of the major sins and most severe.
بأن كان له حكمة في ذلك وعلم وإلا فليبتعد لأن الأمر خطير جدا.
It is not permissible for somebody to get involved in someone else's relationship between the husband and the wife unless it is for the sake of making things better and that they have the knowledge and the wisdom to help them and they know the Islamic rulings of helping them.
وهذه المسألة غالبة في مجتمعات المسلمين إفساد الزوجة على زوجها والسعي في إبعادها عنه هذه غالبة تقع أحيانا من حمية الجاهلية وتقع أحيانا حسدا للمرأة حتى لا تبقى زوجة.
And this problem unfortunately is widespread amongst the Muslims in today's times that people get involved in other people's relationships and cause problems in other people's relationships, in fact. Sometimes it is just due to their ignorance and their disconnection from the deen. Sometimes it is due intentionally to cause problems between husband and wife.
فهذا أمر خطير جدا. فهذا أمر خطير. فلا يجوز للأبي ولا للأم أن يتدخل في الأمور التي تقع بين الزوجين إلا بعد أن يلغي عنه الحمية إلا بعد أن يلغي عنه الحمية وهذا يصعب جدا من أحد الجانبين أن يلغي عنه الحمية هذا أمر خطير وهو الذي تفصل به الأسر دائما
يعني الغضب
نعم السعي بين الزوجين لا يجوز للإنسان أن يدخل بينهما إلا إذا كان يلغي عنه حمية الجاهلية والأغراض النفسية وهذا صعب جدا دائما من اطراف الزوجين.
ما المقصود بحمية الجاهلية؟
أنا لا حمية الجاهلية معناها حب جانب ابنه او بنته حتى يحميه من يقع مثلا يعني الشعور النفسي لينتصر له بدون حق شرعي. لان النفس دائما غالبا تميل الى ابنها اكثر او الى بنتها اكثر. فطبعا الانسان يميل الى هذا، فاذا لم يكن محررا جدا ولا يخاف الميل فلا يجوز له ان يقرب ذلك الجانب خصوصا من الوالد والاقارب هذا غالبا يقع منه الجور في احد الجانبين.
So one thing to beware of especially for parents and relatives to not get involved in the relationships of others of their relative of their son of their daughter unless they know first and foremost that there is no like ego involvement in it. There's no bias that they're just going to be biased towards their son or their daughter or this is my relative and so on. If somebody knows that they really will be fair and just and open and then they can begin to think about getting involved.
والغالب على المجتمعات المسلمة ظلم زوجات أبنائهم هذا غالبا هذا في العصر القديم الذين جاءوا مهاجرين هذا غالبا فيهم ظلم بناتهم هذا الغالب فيهم ظلم بناتهم بنات يعني ما يسمونهم مضر الله الغالب في أم الزوج ظلم زوجات الأبناء هذا هو الغالب في من الذين يأتون من البلاد الخارجة إلى هذا البلد لأنهم تعودوا على ظلم في ذلك وهذا معروف جدا يعني يحسبون أن هذه البنت ستأتي خادمة أو ملكا لهم كالعبودية.
And one of the common injustices that is widespread today especially in immigrant families.
أنت تقول especially الغالب من المهاجرين لا أتكلم عن السنة أتكلم عن الشطر الآخر. المهاجرون
نعم
الذين تحكمت فيهم العصبية الجاهلية في بلاد أوطانهم عندما يأتوا هنا لابد أن يطبقوا ما كانوا يفعلون من الظلم في البلاد. فلذلك تجد دائما الظلم جانب أم الزوج.
The majority of the immigrants coming from countries where the culture is abusive towards the daughter-in-law and there's a lot of injustices in marriage that are involved in that culture. They bring those injustices with them and they treat their daughter-in-law as if she came to them as a servant or a slave or works for them or so on. As if she, her job is a servant and or to be a slave to everyone. So they bring this ignorance along with them.
أن يظلموا الرجل وهذا أمر مستمر جدا هذا شيء مدرستان طاغيتان.
So that was the majority of people who immigrated to this country. And as for the majority of people
وتخلقوا بأخلاق الأمريكان هنا.
As for those who were raised in America or in the West and took the manners and the culture and the character or came and took and became Americanized and took the American culture to heart, then the common thing in that case is the actual abuse of the husband. So then it's like people are ganging up on him day and night.
إذن لابد لمن لابد لمن جاءه زوجان في هذه الأيام يختصمان أن يعرف الأول الهدف الأول هل هما من ذلك الفريق ومن هذا الفريق حتى يعرف كيف يحل العقدة لأن الوضع صعب جدا فالذين يتخلقون بذلك المنهج القديم الفاسد هؤلاء دائما زوجات أبنائهم مظلومات والذين والزوجات التي تربينا هنا وترعنعنا في هذه المدارس يترعرعن بنوع من الفساد وظلم الأزواج وتعبيدهم يعني ما لم يتأمر به الفراعنة.
So whoever is approached for counseling or to get involved and to help the affairs between a husband and a wife, then they should be mindful of these trends. That if it is somebody from overseas, a lot of times they bring a lot of ignorance from their culture with them and the daughter-in-law becomes abused and the wife her rights are not being met and she's being asked and demanded from a lot of things that are not required of her and are unfair to ask from her. And on the other hand, for those who were became more Americanized or grew up in the West, then or went to school here and so on, then their case, unfortunately, is the abuse of the husbands. The wife doesn't know that he has any rights over her, and so on. That there's a lot of transgression going on against the rights of the husband.
فاللاتي ترعرعن هنا وقرأن في الجامعات إنما هن أرباب يعبدن من دون الله سبحانه وجل.
So as far as the ones who were raised here. And went to universities in the West, then they see themselves somehow as idols that are worshipped alongside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إذن أنا قد سئلت ماضيا في شرق أمريكا عن مسألة اختلاف الزوجين فقلت لهم المدرستان ظالمتان هناك مدرستان
So I was asked in the East Coast about the relationships and how to fix relationships. And I said that there are two approaches that are both oppressive. There are two views of schools of thought, you could say, that are both oppressive.
فالذين يتبعون الغرب خصوصا البيضة من أمريكا إن الزوجة شيطانة والزوج قط تحتها لا يمكنه أن يخرج ولا يدخل ولا يتنفس إلا وهي تعلم بذلك ويستأذنها.
So then, as for the couple with the Western norms, then what happens is the husband becomes like a kitten in the hands of his wife, that he cannot come in or out or eat or go to the bathroom without her permission, as if he is completely under her control.
وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بِلَادِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ الَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مُهَاجِرِينَ وَمَنْ يَقْتَدُونَ بِهِمْ كَمَا نَقُولُ نُسَمِّهِ الْمَشْرِقِ الْأَوْسَطِ فَهَؤُلَاءِ شَيَاطِينَ وَالْأَمَةُ عِنْدَهُمْ الزَّوْجَ عِنْدَهُمْ نَوْعٌ مِنَ الْعَبُودِيَ وَالتَّعْلِيمِ لا يقدر عليها تكلف ما لا تطيقه.
And then as far as the people with the ignorant mentality as well, the other ignorant mentality of that they bring with them from overseas, that they treat the wife as a slave. As you call the Middle East, that come from the Middle East, they treat their wives. Or Afghanistan, Pakistan, etc. And even people coming from Africa, then they treat their wives, unfortunately, as if they are slaves.
إذن الذي يحل المشاكل الآن هو الرجوع إلى شرع الله تعالى حتى نحكمه. فلن يحل لنا أمريكا شيء ولن تحل لنا الجاهلية الماضية شيء. لن يحل أمور الزواج غير أن نرجع إلى كتاب الله تعالى وسنة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم ونحكمهما فيما بيننا.
So the solution is simple. You cannot go to cultural norms from the Middle East to solve the problem, and you cannot rely on Western norms to solve the problem. Rather, the solution is only in returning to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be the judge between our matters and to follow it entirely.
وَلَا نَتَّهِمَ شَرْعَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ
And to not accuse it and to not have any ill will against the religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed for us.
وَنَرْجِعَ إِلَىٰ قَوْلِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ
And we go back to what Allah has said, that if you dispute in a matter, then return it to Allah and His Messenger if you believe in Allah and the Last Day.
فَلَمْ تَحُلَّ لَكُمْ أَعْرَافَ أَفْغَانِسْتَانَ وَالْمَشْرِقِ الْأَوْسَطِ شَيْئًا إِنَّمَا تَزِيدُكُمْ فَشَلًا وَفَشَلًا وَوَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ إِنَّ سْبِيكَرَ فِي أَمْرِكَ وَالْمُحَامِينَ إِنَّهُمْ أَفْسَدُوا مِنْ أُولَئِكَ الْقَوْمِ
So the scholars, so the culture of Afghanistan and whatever any in the Middle East or Africa, the culture there, it will not be your savior. It will not be your solution. And I swear by Allah that the speakers here in America are. And the lawyers and the people, the counselors and so on here are much, much more damaging to the relationships than even the cultural traditions from the Middle East. Because both are judging by other than what Allah has revealed. And as Allah says, and whoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, indeed they are the transgressors, the sinful transgressors. In another verse, and the one who does not judge by what Allah has revealed, then indeed they are the blasphemers or the disbelievers.
إذن الذين هنا يتحكمون إلى أصحاب مساجد الأعراف المهاجرين هنا فستغلم الزوجة غالبا إلا يعني الكبار تغلم الزوجة غالبا لأنهم سيرجعون إلى العرف العرف الذي كانوا يعتادونه إلا من تخلق منهم بأخلاق أمريكا ومن والذين يرجعون إلى المحامين هنا والمحاضرين في أمريكا وأطباء النفس فإن الزوجة سيغلم ظلما لا نهاية له.
So the ones who will resort to the Eastern culture for their solution, then what will happen in the relationship, it will remain imbalanced and the wife will be oppressed and that strain will be upon the relationship and the problem will increase. And as for the ones who are judge according to the Western culture or the lawyers or whatever, the counselors, the lawyers, especially the lawyers and the psychiatrists and so on, some of the counselors, then they will cause, and the speakers, they will be unfortunately the relationship will remain to be imbalanced, but this time against the husband, and the strain will remain upon the relationship and will not be healed.
ولا ينبئك مثل خبير انا اقول لكم والله الذي لا اله الا هو لن تصلحوا ما دمتم ترجعون الى هذين الفريقين لن يصلح لكم زواج ما دمتم ترجعون الى هذين الفريقين.
And the one with experience can tell you, I can tell you clearly, absolutely, that you will not have a satisfactory solution. You will not get the best outcome. You will not succeed if you keep on returning to these two options.
لن يصلح لكم زواج ولا قوام ما دمتم ترجعون إلى هذين الفريقين.
Your marriages will not be corrected and balanced and fixed if you keep on coming to these two oppressive groups.
تلك حمية المشرق وجاهليتها وهذا كفر المغرب الغرب وجاهليته.
And that's the ignorance and the cultural leaning and bias of the Middle East. And this is the ignorance and the cultural leanings and bias and oppression of the West.
قوانين الكفر.
The laws of disbelief.
والله قال لكم ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الكافرون.
And Allah is telling you, as for those who judge by other than what Allah has revealed, those are the disbelievers. That is befitting for the disbelievers only.
وإن كنتم تتهربون مما قال الله ورسوله فلكم تهمة بالله ورسوله.
نعم فنعم.
وإن كنتم تتهربون مما قال الله ورسوله فلكم غن بالله ورسوله أو علم بأنهما وحشهما يظلمان.
So then, if you are intentionally running away from what Allah has revealed, and you don't want to know, and you want to avoid and dodge and interpret and get away from what Allah has revealed and what the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught, then this is very dangerous, because this indicates that you feel or you believe that Allah and His Messenger are oppressive.
ويصدق فيكم قول الله تعالى في الكافرين أم يخافون أن يحيف الله عليهم ورسوله بل أولئك هم الظالمون.
And then if you do so, then you would make the verse that Allah has said versus the disbelievers apply to you, where Allah says once they are called for Allah and the Messenger to judge between them, what does Allah say? As opposed to the believers, what do the disbelievers do? Allah asks, are they afraid that Allah and His Messenger would behave, would judge them unjustly, would transgress against them unjustly?
بل أولئك هم الظالمون.
Rather, indeed, those are the oppressors.
إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا وأولئك هم المفلحون.
Indeed, the statement of the believers, once they are called to Allah and His Messenger to judge between them, that they would say, we hear and we obey. وأولئك
هم المفلحون.
And indeed, they are the successful ones.
ومن يطع الله ورسوله ويخشى الله ويتقيه فأولئك هم الفائزون.
And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger and fears Allah and guards himself by obeying the commands of Allah and has a fear of Allah, then those are the winners.
هنالك ناس يتهربون ويبتعدون أن يقالوا إن الرجال قوامون.
Those some people they
كثير من الناس.
نعم كيف يعني؟
كثير ممن يسمى علماء.
A lot of the people who are so-called scholars, they try to escape and try to interpret, and they say as an excuse, they say that Allah said that the men are responsible guardians, watchers, overseers.
الرجال قوام أمراء أمراء ماذا نفعل أمراء قال ابن عباس أمراء.
As Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said, the men are the guardians, the overseers, the responsible ones, leaders, meaning as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, قال, that he said that they are the ones in charge, they are the ones that are the leaders.
لكن هل قال الأمراء يظلمون يجوز لهم أن يظلمون.
But when you say that the men are supposed to be the leaders, does this mean that they're supposed to be oppressive leaders? Or it's permissible for them to be oppressive? Did Allah tell the leaders, do whatever you want? No.
لا يلزم من كونه أميراً أن يظلم بل يلزم من كونه أميراً أن يعدل.
What is befitting of the responsibility that Allah has given to be a leader in a relationship is not to be unjust and to oppress the other and to take advantage of that position, but it is to show justice and goodness.
لذلك بيّن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال والرجل راع كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته إلى أن قال والرجل راع وهو مسؤول عن امرأته عن رعيته عن زوجته هل مرع أمير أو مأمور.
So then we clearly, so this is according to the Quran. Now this is understood in the hadith as well. The Prophet ﷺ said that every one of you is a shepherd and is responsible for his flock. And then what was mentioned as the flock of a man was his wife. And so the one who is in the flock and the one who is the shepherd, which one is the leader?
هل قال والمرأة مسؤولة عن زوجها؟ لا قال مسؤولة عن بيتها وما فيه.
Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say that the woman is responsible for her husband? She'll be asked about why did you let him do this or that? No, Allah said, or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that she is responsible for her household, for inside, for her household.
أنا أقول لكم إذا قال الله لكم ورسوله وأوضح النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ماذا تريدون بعد ذلك؟ تريدون الفساد في الأرض ونشر الفتنة؟
نعم.
إذا قال الله ورسوله الله قال وبين رسوله وأوضح وضاحا توضيحا بينا ماذا تريدون بعد ذلك غير نشر الفتنة؟
So if you want, if you hear now the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you hear the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explaining and detailing a very clear, painting a very obvious and clear picture, then if, by leaning away from it, by trying to explain something else, then what are you trying to spread? Are you trying to spread goodness or are you trying to increase the problems and spread the fitna?
نعم تريدون أن تنشروا الفتنة حتى لا يبقى مأمور ولا آمر حتى يكون هناك أميران وخلاص.
Yes, you do want to spread the fitna. You want it.
To the point that
there are two leaders.
تريدون أن تنشروا الفتنة.
You want to spread corruption.
تريدون أن تفسدوا العلاقة الزوجية. تريدون أن تنشروا الطلاق.
You want to cause problems between people in their relationships, and to cause divorce amongst the people.
تريدون أن يتيتموا البنات والأبناء.
You want to separate the children from their parents like orphans. You want to make the boys and the girls like orphans.
تريدون أن تجعلوا الأصدقاء والصديقات في الشوارع.
You want to make boyfriends and girlfriends walking together in the streets.
وقع ذلك الذي أردتم.
What you have tried to cause has happened.
This is happening right now.
Your goal is already realized. Your goal is already realized. It's already found.
لا يمكن الآن الزواج الإسلامي مطلقا في المسلمين الآن إلا ما ندر لا يمكن الزواج تعذر الآن تعذر لا يمكن الزواج.
Right now, unfortunately, the proper Islamic marriage is not found. It's impossible.
تعذر تعذر الزواج الآن لا يمكن لأحد الآن أن يتزوج يخاف الزواج لما يقع من الفساد.
It's unfortunately impossible right now because of what happens and because of the problems, people are excused. And now it's excused, the Islamic marriage, because of all the different obstacles and the culture and so on, as if people are excused from getting married.
لا يوجد الآن إلا صريح الزنا لتصعيب الزواج.
Because of how difficult it is to become married and to be married and the norms of marriage. And getting married, what people are encouraged toward and what is going on is that people stay in a state of fornication.
نعم تصعيب الحلال ونشر الحرام هذا هو.
So what is happening is the halal is being made very difficult and the haram is being widespread.
وهذا مصداق لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سيأتي قوم من أمتي يستحلون الربا والخمر والزنا.
Just as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there will come a people from my ummah who permit interest and musical instruments and fornication and alcohol.
الآن لو هل سمعتم ناس الآن يتكلمون عن الزنا وشرب الخمر لا لكن يتكلمون فلان تزوج ثانية فلان يعني تزوج كذا لماذا ما يفعل كذا؟ لماذا لا يكون كذا؟ لماذا فلانة ما طلبت حقها من زوجها وطلقت؟ وتقع المشاكل حتى يقع.
What do you hear? What do you hear the speakers complaining about? Do you hear them speaking about the state of emergency in regard to all the fornication that is going on, in regard to the alcoholism that people are drinking alcohol? Oh, look, such and such person was, not such and such, but people are getting involved in these sins and so on. Or are they focusing their energy and their attention? Oh, look, that person got married. Oh, why doesn't she just divorce this person? Why doesn't, she seek divorce in her relationship and so on? So, yes, they want them to divorce so that she goes to fornication and he goes to fornication. So, yes.
النساء الآن 80% على الأقل على الأقل.
So yes, they would say divorce, and then what happens, unfortunately, is that the fornication becomes so widespread. Now, unfortunately, at least 80% of the women are involved in this great sin.
و75 كما قيل لي في كاليفورنيا قبل سنين مطلقات.
And 75% or close to that. As people said in California, the divorce rate is that 75% of marriages are ending in divorce. A few years ago that this was mentioned. And things are getting worse.
اسمعوا 80% بالأصل و75 منها طلقت ماذا سيقع؟
So then it is 80% of people to begin with who are involved in fornication, and now 75% of them who got married are getting divorced. So what's going to happen?
ماذا سيقع من الزواج؟ قد تكون 1% متزوج، 1% إذا كانت محظوظة.
So what's going to happen to marriage then? 1% of people then, maybe 1% or less will be involved in a proper and happy marriage if they're lucky.
الفساد أو الصبر على الأذى لا بد من الفساد وهذا والغالب الزنا وهذا أكثر من 90 والباقي على الصبر على الصبر فقط على الصبر على الصبر.
So the rest are either will be in a state of fornication, an abandonment of marriage, or inability to be married, and in a state of fornication, and others, and the rest will be in a state of just bitter patience, dealing with a harsh, you know, relationship, or really struggling and suffering. So more, so the minority will be suffering and abstaining from fornication. More than 90% will be involved in fornication.
والقليل الذي يريد شرع الله تعالى وليس شرع الحقيقة لأنه ولا يريد الشرع أيضا ولكن قال شيء لا يزني
حقيقة. And then the minority, they will be those who want to practice the deen.
ولكن لا يريد الدين حقيقة. إلا أنهم لا يزني.
And in reality, they won't. They're not properly following the deen, but at least they will be avoiding fornication.
لذلك هذا سعي في طلاق المسلمين والمسلمات سعي حثيث جدا بل لعدم الزواج أصلا من أصله سعي فيما يقع القليل من الزواج لإفصاله والسعي الأول لقطعه من الأصل هذا هو القطع الأصيلي والذي وقع منه تقع مثلا ترتيبات لفراق الزوجين.
So then all of these different cultural and societal factors, what are they causing? They're causing a struggle in order to get married in the first place, a war against marriage and obstacles, placing many cultural obstacles so that it makes it very difficult to get married. And then those same cultural norms and so on, once people are married, then unfortunately, people are striving to ruin that relationship and to separate between the husband and the wife.
فإذا تزوج الغالب أيضا أن يقع الطلاق منها الأمر هو قليل من قليل الغالب ابتداء أن يحجز من الزواج هذا هو الغالب وإذا وقع ذلك القليل فالغالب من ذلك القليل أن يقع الطلاق.
So the majority is struggling to even get married and being blocked from marriage, and the ones that do get married, the few that make it through and get married, then they're facing the struggles against them that are corrupting their marriage and ruining their marriage and causing imbalance in their relationship.
ما لا يكون هؤلاء الذين يسعون في هذا الأمر ما لا يقع فيهم من نص كتاب الله العزيز ما لا يقع فيهم بعيد.
So those who are spreading these norms that are causing these effects against marriage, what is going to happen to them? What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about these people?
قال الله سبحانه إن الذين يحبون أن تشيع الفاحشة في الذين آمنوا لهم عذاب أليم في الدنيا والآخرة والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون.
Allah said, those who love to see the shamelessness and the sinfulness become widespread. هنا الفاحشة يعني زنا والفاحشة
يعني ولكن دائما يطلقون على الزنا ولكن الزنا من أكبر الفواحش.
So those who love to see the shamelessness, widespread shameless sinfulness, and especially fornication widespread amongst the people, what does Allah say? Allah says those who love to see this فاحشة spread amongst the believers, they will have a severe torment. In this world and the hereafter. So those who are doing this, they should await a very severe torment and disgrace in this world, and what is waiting for them with Allah is more severe and everlasting.
وقد رأيناهم والحمد لله نزلت بهم عقوبة في هذه الدار قد رأيناهم والحمد لله وما عند الله أشد وأبقى.
And we have seen, alhamdulillah, as Allah has promised, many of these people who are corrupting the society, that they have been disgraced in this world, and alhamdulillah, and what is waiting for them with Allah, if their state does not change, is more severe.
وأعتقد أنكم أيها المترجم والحاضرون والمشاهدون تعلمون ما وقع فيه وأنتم تعلمون وأنا أعلمه معكم.
And I think that you who is translating and the speakers who are watching and listening and viewing this, they know exactly this trend and that this has happened to people, that people have been, unfortunately, are in this state and have seen the consequences of their actions.
صحيح؟ رأيتم بأعينكم ذلك؟ رأيتم بأعينكم ذلك؟
Is this true? Have you seen this with your own eyes?
ذلك بأعينكم الذين كانوا هنا يجمعون النساء والرجال ويخلطون خلطهم ولا يسعون في النكاح ولا يسعون في شيء وعندما تأتي المرأة بينها وبين زوجها الأحسن لكم أن تتطلقوا والوغ تقع مشاكل ويذهبوا إلى هذا الطبيب وهذا المحامي.
What have you seen? What have you seen? What are the outcomes of the one who gathered men and women in gatherings without taking care to have a modesty in the gathering, and then so spreading the fitna, the temptation among them, and then the few, the ones that were saved from the fornication and the problems that ended up getting married, and then they taught them wrong norms in the relationship. And incited the wives against their husbands and so on. And then once they come for counseling, then they cause them to be divorced. And then what happens to these people?
رأيتهم الآن في العقوبة. نعم أنا أعرف أنكم رأيتهم في العقوبة. لا أريد أن أسميهم على فيسبوك ولكن تعلمون أنهم في العقوبة الآن.
Do you see that these people are in a state of torment right now, that they're living a life filled with torment, the people who are spreading this? I don't want to name their names, but you know that they are in a state of torment.
تعلمونهم؟
Yes.
قولوا ما تعلمونهم. ذلك جزاء من يعصي الله. ذلك جزاء من يعصي الله. ذلك جزاء من ينشر الفتنة في المسلمين.
This is the reward of the one who spreads the fitna amongst the Muslims. This is the reward of the one. This is the outcome of the one who disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and spreads corruption amongst the believers.
أنا أعرف رجل من المحاضرين الآن أعرفه بالذات لا أريد أن أسميه وأنتم تعلمون ولكن لا أريد أن أسميه أمامكم اسمعوا هذه القصة حتى تفهموا سفاهة الرجال الآن وضعف عقولهم
أو شيخ عندي ممكن خمس دقائق من الشحن
تفضل
so then نعم the قصة منهم
أنا أعرف يعني رجلا حتى تعلموا سفاهة الرجال الآن وأنتم تعلمون الرجل لكن لا أريد أن أسميه من المحاضرين
Just so you know the foolishness of some of these men today, there's an incident with one of the speakers and some people may know him that is exemplifies this foolishness.
قال لي إنه دعاه رجل يصلح بينه وبين زوجته ف لا لا دعته امرأة ليصلح بينها وبين زوجها فاستأذن من زوجها طبعا قال له أنا زوجتك قالت لي أنني إنها تريد أن أتكلم بينكما حتى أصلح بينكما فقال نعم فقال وأيضا زوجته هو اتصلت على زوجتي لتطمئنها لي راضية بأن أتكلم بينهما
So then a man said that a woman, one of the speakers who was called a scholar, he was approached by a woman was approached by a woman who husband to make sure that he wanted this counseling. مراتن
كانت بينها وبين زوجها مشكلة فطلبت منه أن يأتي
نعم So she asked the speaker to come and judge in their case. And his wife, and so he checked with the husband, and his wife checked with her to make sure that they're happy.
هو هو الذي قال لي قال وهي أيضا تأدبت معنا سألت زوجتي هل يمكن أن أتكلم بينهما.
And he said that he said that she had the good manners to talk to my wife to see if I could counsel them and help them out.
اسمعوا هذا المحاضر ليسمى عالما.
So listen to this speaker who is called a scholar.
قال إنها هي أيضا تكلمت مع زوجته واستأذنتها لأجل أن يتكلم بينهما.
He said that this lady, to seek counseling from me, got permission from my wife that I could give her counseling.
هذا هو معنى تغيير كتاب الله تعالى. الرجال قوامون على النساء معنى أن هي تستوى هذا جيد وهو هذا محاضر ويسمى عالما. اسمعوا هذا الكلام.
And this is the case, unfortunately, that people are in, that they have flipped this guardianship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given, and who is the shepherd and who is the flock, that now this person who's a speaker, who's called a scholar, for him to give counseling to a family, now his wife has to be sought for permission first because she's the one in charge. So do you who are present and you who are viewing, do you think that the state of the Muslims can be fixed while they are adopting these norms?
لا اعتقد ان المسلمين عندهم حل الان الا ان يظهر المهدي لان هذا الوضع الان الذي هم فيه يعني اعوذ بالله
I don't think the Muslims have a solution until the Mahdi comes because the state that they are in right now I seek Allah's refuge from it is a very severe state.
اسمعوا رجل يسمي نفسه عالما ويقود مؤسسة و يقول المرأة أيضا استأذنت زوجتي.
Listen to this guy who calls himself a scholar and he has whatever institute he has or organization that he has, and he is saying that, oh, and this lady had the good manners to get permission from my wife so I can give her counseling.
معناها انه ليس مسؤول عن رأي هذا بنت هذا الرجل هذا ليس طفل هذا طفلة صغيرة معناها ذات 3 سنين حتى ما سمعنا في هذه الأيام بنت تستأذن والدها والعياذ بالله ما سمعنا بنت صغيرة الآن تستأذن والدها والعياذ بالله من غضب الله.
So this person unfortunately then is not the one who is in charge of his flock it seems. Rather now he is like a child. To his wife, and rather he's like a young daughter, and actually not a daughter, because we do not hear today of a daughter that seeks permission from her parents.
أعوذ بالله. وهذا فساد منها ولكن إلى درجة صار أسوأ من البنات هذا فساد منها.
So this is wrong on her part.
ولكنه هو أقل مقاما من بنت مع والديها.
But he is in a seemingly now in a lower state or a more humbled state than a daughter with her parents.
معناها أنتم بلداء لا تصلحون للإصلاح ولا للزواج لا تصلحون لإصلاح الناس بل لا تصلحون للزواج.
So someone in the state, then what are the people who are adopting this? You, what is your state then? You are not just unfit to counsel people in their marriages. You are unfit to be married then. You're not fit to be married yourself.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج القدرة على أمور النكاح وأنت لست قادر على أمور النكاح.
So as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that whoever is able to handle the responsibilities, O youth, whoever is able to handle the responsibilities of marriage, the burdens, then they can become married. the ability, they have the physical, financial, so on capability to be married, then they should get married. This person then is not able to handle the responsibilities. So that means that you, unfortunately, are not fit to be married, much less to give people counseling. So please, do not get married to a woman so that you can corrupt her and corrupt others. If you are not fit for your wife or even fit for yourself, then how are you fit to counsel others and tell others how to behave?
انتهى لأنك بعيد وبارك الله فيكم وحفظكم الله وإلى لقاء آخر نكمل فيه الدرس إن شاء الله.
بارك الله فيكم وسامحونا إن شاء الله جزاكم خير. Forgive me everyone for my shaky thing and my delays. بارك الله فيكم إن شاء الله. We'll be seeing you soon.
Abubakar, is there class tomorrow?
It'll be very difficult. We can have it at a different time.
نستطيع
أن نفعل الدرس في وقت مختلف بدري
غدا. لا 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 تفعل. خليه غدا إن شاء الله حتى أنا. بيجي لهم أن الدرس غير موجود إلى 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 الويكند الآتي.
So inshallah we will be giving we'll delay the class until the following weekend.
أنت مسافر.
I'm traveling. I'm out of state, unfortunately.
إن شاء الله يوم السبت الآتي ننتظر فغدا إن شاء الله سنلغي الدرس.
So tomorrow's class unfortunately is cancelled. My apologies.
بارك الله فيكم.
بارك الله فيكم.